If you answered async task, then you're correct. To understand why we chose async task as the answer, we can check the developer documentation. In this API guide on processes and threads, we can scroll to the worker threads section. By the way, if you want to follow along, the link is included below. Say, for example, that you want to download an image from the network at this URL, and then you want to update the UI so that it displays this bitmap. Well, creating your own thread to download the image is a valid option, but there's a lot of overhead to handle in making your app actually thread safe. After you download your image, you cannot directly update the UI from a background thread. However, Android has several options to run code that manipulates the UI from other threads. In this example, yet another runnable is created to get the bitmap result back onto the main thread to update the image view. This solution is a little cumbersome because you have to manage two runnables here. To abstract away this complexity, we can use an async task. And then to kick off the async task, for example, when someone clicks a button, then you just initialize the task, and then you can call execute on it, and then pass in any parameters that are needed. Notice that when you're extending the async class, there's a couple of generics that you need to specify. The first is the type that will be passed into the doInBackground method. So if you want to pass in this image URL, then you specify string here, and then in doInBackground, you'll get a string parameter. The second one is for the type of object that you'll get when you get progress updates as the task gets executed. We're not using that here, so it's okay to specify that as void. And the third type is type of result that we'll be sending back to the main thread through the onPostExecute method.